Scott, we are on the eve of one of the most heavily anticipated pay-per-view events in recent memory. Bash at the Beach, the big main event tag team matchup that you're talking about. And it's the former World Heavyweight Champion, by the way, Hollywood Hulk Hogan, who is going to be one dangerous individual. Beware Diamond Dallas Page. Beware mailman Carl Malone. It's the ex-World Heavyweight Champion, and who knows what frame of mind, what mindset the former World Heavyweight Champion Hollywood Hogan is going to be in without that belt. And of course, he's going to be bringing Rodzilla Dennis Rodman as his tag team partner into San Diego.
It's going down at the Cox Arena tomorrow night on pay-per-view. And we talk about Hollywood Hogan being the former champion. Everybody knows what went down last Monday night at the Georgia Dome in Atlanta as Goldberg became the World Heavyweight Champion, defeating Hollywood Hogan in that classic. 41,000 plus on their feet, chanting Goldberg in the Georgia Dome, Mike. It was a moment I will never forget.
There have been some memorable moments, some historical occasions throughout the 2.5 year history of Monday Nitro, but last Monday at the Georgia Dome and live on a national TNT audience was absolutely off the charts. Everyone that I've spoken to since that event, they just seem to remember so many things from this past Monday night's event. The return of Buff Bagwell, Goldberg having to go through Scott Hall to get that eventual world's title shot, and then that big payoff when Goldberg defeated Hollywood Hogan. Everyone that I have spoken with talks about their ears still ringing as 41,000 fans celebrated along with Goldberg, that new World's Heavyweight Champion. And we hope it's going to be a very long reign for Goldberg at the top of the wrestling world.
Much more on Goldberg still to come tonight on Saturday night. Starting us off, Judo Suwa and Sumo Fuji taking on the Public Enemy, Johnny Grunge and Rocco Rock. Double reverse and oh boy! Suwa and Fuji really being hammered by Rocco and Johnny. Double clothesline by the Public Enemy.
And smartly, Suwa and Fuji roll out to the floor. An opportunity for them to regroup. Public Enemy, as of late, certainly been on quite a winning streak here in World Championship Wrestling. They're doing everything they can to move up the rankings of the tag team list here in World Championship Wrestling. The executive committee obviously taking a very, very close look at all of the Public Enemy recent tag bouts.
Right now, Sumo Fuji really giving it to Johnny Grunge. Shoots him into the corner. Sumo Fuji charges in, and Johnny with the elbow, with the 30, the kick in the chest, and the neck breaker from Johnny Grunge.
Well, in terms of experience as a tag team, a huge edge for Public Enemy. Also factor in the size advantage that they have here. And when you look at that, Public Enemy has to be labeled as prohibitive favorites against Judo Suwa and Sumo Fuji. Although we've certainly been impressed with these two youngsters from Ultimo Dragon's training school in Mexico City.
No question about it, when you're trained by Ultimo Dragon, you have an immense future in professional wrestling. And Judo Suwa and Sumo Fuji know if they listen to Dragon, they're going to go places. But right now, all they can hear are the chops from Flyboy Rocco Rock across the chest of Judo Suwa, right into the face. Now, reversal by Judo. Rocco, oh, misses the moonsault.
Tried that moonsault back into the ring, did not connect, and that possibly opens up the door and a chance for Suwa and Fuji to take advantage. Let's see if they can mount some kind of an offense.
Judo Suwa going up top, no go, Public Enemy.
Oh my!
Almost threw him into the eighth row.
Sumo Fuji now into the ring.
Shoots him in, waits on him, right across the knee. The double gut buster by the Mac Daddies of Violence, the Public Enemy.
They continue the double team tactics. Looks like we're going to see the drive-by.
Hello, Sumo, good night. The cover, the leg, and the three count. Flyboy Rocco Rock and Johnny. Oh, hang on a second. Disco Inferno and Alex Wright have hit the ring, and they are opening up on the Public Enemy. What in the world?
Look at Alex Wright put the boots to Flyboy Rocco Rock. Meanwhile, on the opposite side of the ring, the same thing is happening as Disco Inferno attacks Johnny Grunge.
And they get a little disco dancing in there. This is terrible.
Disco Inferno and Alex Wright celebrate like they actually won the matchup. Public Enemy, well, they certainly won the battle, but as this matchup evolves, it turns out that they're going to lose the war.
What Cheap Shot artists Disco Inferno and Alex Wright are, no question.
Bottom line, Public Enemy gets the win as we open Saturday night.